Hey y'all, what is up YouTube, how's it going y'all? Sparky Marky Mark, and I'm back. So how was Cyber Week, and among other things, and especially I haven't done my haul video yet for Black Weekend or Cyber Week, because heck, some of the items that I ordered through Vinegar Syndrome hadn't arrived yet. When it does, I'm going to be doing that video pretty soon as possible. Heck, we're in December though, so yeah. So anyway, let's get back, no chit-chat, let's get to this item. Let's get to this product that I'm about to show you. This product, that is. And it's a G-Shock watch, but it depends on what are we looking at. What, if you've seen my previous video about the Mudman and the history of it, you're looking at this going back like years ago. I already mentioned this to you. And I don't know much about these other ones. I haven't seen no more version, except there was a pink and purple sunrise purple edition, or the pink, if you will, released in 2014. But I'll get to that in another video. With that, we're looking at the Mudman. All right, GX, the GX series, like I mentioned, they are also Mudman's, part of their mud resist with their buttons. If I told you about the what was it, the DW5500C-1 G-Shock 2, that was hardly a Mudman, and it wasn't well received to the public. That's kind of hard to track, and I already mentioned one of these in the vids. Oh, sorry about that. I also mentioned in these vids that all these Mudman, some of them are easy, some of them are very hard to find, some of them are very rare. 25th anniversary, Black Dawn Black, and you have the TLC, Team Land Cruiser, or Toyota Land Cruiser, if you will. Some of them are maintaining $184, some of them are going $200 because of the technology packed into them, and some of them are going to have to find pieces to where they all fit together. So yeah. And also, let's see what's about to go on. Go to the next section. And what you're looking at here, folks, is various Mudmans shown in films, seen in movies, of course. Except for that one, that's a G79. Ignore that. That's hardly a Mudman. And I don't know much about this. I've never seen a Mudman with that look before with a different display. And this one is appearing in the voice of Sean Penn in a different film, if I'm not mistaken. Donnie Wahlberg wore a Mudman, or nah, it's a different watch, a different G-Shock. But also, you have the updated versions and also other things. That is Arnold Schwarzenegger's G-Shock 2, the Mudman, if you will, as he wore in the final act of The Running Man. And this would later be appearing in wrists of other actors. I believe the, I forgot what was his name. Comment me in the comments down below if I missed any actor who wore a G-Shock watch in the film. Or a Mudman, a G-Shock Mudman in a movie. Please correct me. So, yeah. And also, the particular one that you're about to see was worn in two films over the course of a few years. One worn by Aaron Eckhart in the 2011 hit film Battle of Los Angeles, and Lawrence Fishburne in the 2009 film Armored. Mm-hmm. You can tell very precisely that this is indeed the timepiece you're about to see. And with that, no chit chat, let's head to the watch, like right now. Let's go. Here you go, y'all. This is what you're about to see here, folks. But it doesn't have the right module number. This is just a different box that can fit with the tin in it. That's enough. Let's slide it out. And it comes with a different warranty. It comes with some sort of manual. You can leave it as long as it's charging in the sun. Comes in some languages. Let's be clear, you can buy this in Japan. Written in Portuguese and other foreign languages. I don't understand. Okay. France, Dutch, English. Okay, that's enough with this. Warranty card, very important. Christy, what do we have here? Oh. Say hello to the GW9000A-1, I believe. GW9000A-1. Oh, yeah. Very good, very good. This is coined, as some G-Shock collectors coined this watch as, the 5i Monster, is what it's called. The 5i Monster. Mm-hmm. I mean, it has from a distance, maybe it has a consistency of the G9000 body, sure. But it's tough solar multiband 5. Let me just zoom a little bit. Hold it. Uh-huh. You have the towers for the US, UK, GE, I assume Geneva, and also other two sections of Japan. They have the radio towers. That's right, folks. Whoa. Gonna maintain its position for a moment. Okie dokie. So, yeah, let me just zoom out a little bit. Okay. There we go. So, yeah, folks, this is what you're getting, and it's a pretty good piece. And with that, let me just take it out of here for a moment. Heck. All right. You got the A time, which does the whole aerial thing. I can't even tell what that does. Stopwatch. Not even a split one. And since it's kind of like a waist scepter here. Hold on. I think I'm showing it the wrong angle. Okay. You're in NYC, which we are in the East Coast. Your stopwatch. Your timer, kind of like consistency of a wave scepter, kind of like. You only get a 60-minute timer. Oh, well, it is how it is. You got your alarms. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... Alarm, and back to here. And you're back to this. Cool loom shot, I'll show you the end of this vid. And, the A.EL, aerial electroluminescent, when you tilt your wrist, it lights up. Huh, maybe I can just, there you go. It depends on the limitations of the electroluminescent backlight. Let me see something about that. Okay. I don't see any limitations of putting the light in any seconds, unfortunately. And let's be clear, it's the same band that it's on the previous editions of the mud of the how do you call it, the battery powered ones. It's a 716H11PUR. And some people know everyone likes double buckles. They're pretty cool. And I like the double buckles anyway. I don't care, I like them. Like all the Masters of G, each one has their character icons. The first Mud Man had its just the wheels and like an ATV vehicle. The solar power Mudmans would have mole with a dish and a drill. Mud resist atomic timekeeping mode. A solar atomic Mudman. Mud resist, that is. Module 3050. Released sometime around in the year of 2006. And some of that, of course, some actors passed on that particular year, such as veteran actor Dennis Weaver. You might know him from Touch of Evil. He played the motel caretaker. Was also in the Steven Spielberg film, low-budget film called Duel, where he's being harassed by a mysterious truck driver on a big rig. And also would later be playing other characters, playing the role of Sam McCloud in the TV series McCloud and came back to do the TV movies, went on to do other projects in his career. And also, maybe I won't mention that in another video, but it's tribute to the comment that I wrote for the AKB48 music video. Maybe I'll just talk about Japanese music since some other time. That same year, good films came out, The Da Vinci Code, the first installment of the Da Vinci Code movies, and starring Tom Hanks, and also Curious George was released that year, and other cool films, John Carl Beekler film called The Eden Formula, under its pseudonym Tyrannosaurus Rex, WRCEKS. Also, The Fast and the Furious 3 Tokyo Drift. That was a good film. And that was also for stuntman actor Ted White's final stunt performing in his career, because he retired at age 80. That was his last motion picture film he did. And yeah, and we get this along with other good pieces that were out at that time. Cell phone was a big thing, and and PSP was ruling the waves of people collectors. So yeah, I mean, seriously, look at this. It's very good. And with that, let's see the measurements. All right. So here, approximately, it's about, let me see very, very carefully. Okay, so the width is about 45.3 millimeters. Case height size, hold it. One five point four millimeters. I repeat, 15.4 millimeters. Here you go. Lug width to lug width, if I'm not mistaken. 51.2 millimeters. The buttons, they're just mud resist. All mud resist all the way. And and put this watch back in position, like right now, y'all. Okie dokie then. With that, I'm going to be playing a little music from 2006 to represent this piece. From this artist, Papa Roach, with the song, To Be Loved. Alrighty. Did you all enjoy this vid? This is from, that's from 2006, y'all, and this piece represents it. So tell me, you all enjoyed it? Pretty sure you have, and you're satisfied as well. So like the vid, share the vids, comment, ask me questions, and heck, other things. Heck. And also, I'm recording this as of right now, heck. Even though I'm a few minutes behind, heck, it's the anniversary, it's the 80th anniversary of Pearl Harbor, and also it's my buddy's birthday. Happy birthday to you, Kirski Films. Jack Kirski's his name. Happy birthday to you, buddy. So follow him on his YouTube channel. Link's already in the description down below. Also, give you a heads up, you got less than about a few hours till the ending of the private signing of Sean Astin. Who you all remember him from, Goonies, Toy Soldiers, and anything else. That's all there is. And also Encino Man, and among other things. So, yeah. So, yeah, the autograph ends today, but approximately around sometime around noon today. Just to be clear, if I'm not mistaken, it's going to be in the description box down below. So it ends, not today, sorry if I said today, it ends tomorrow, about December the 8th. So yeah, just to let you all know. So anyways, this is Sparky Marky Mark signing off, y'all. Take care, God bless you. Feliz Navidad, y'all. Catch you on the next vid.